See what happened and who is leaving the jungle. I'm a Celebrity, live tonight, 9 o'clock.
Get comfortable with Dreams, Britain's favourite bed specialist.
Six ordinary people. They all look decent, honest, trustworthy. But looks can be deceptive, because for the next hour...
I'm just not buying it. I just don't feel it.
Five total liars.
They're prepared to do whatever it takes.
Do you actually care what happens to me when I walk out this studio?
Failure is not an option.
To become the great pretender. Welcome to The Great Pretender, where the only way to be a winner is to pretend that you're a loser. Six people are about to be tested on their general knowledge, but the unusual thing about this show is that they won't be told whether the answers they give are right or not. So all the players have to keep track of how they're doing, and also how their opponents are doing, because being the highest scorer doesn't guarantee success in this game. Only if they can hide that victory can they keep the cash and become the Great Pretender. Let's meet today's contenders. We've got Katie Whitehead, a student from Cheltenham in Gloucestershire, who is studying creative writing. Wayne Tritton, a sales executive from Berkshire, who loves playing practical jokes. Catherine Ormiston, a marketing manager from East Sussex, who is a fantastic bluffer. Glenn Gathercole from London, who holds down three jobs and says he is a ruthless interrogator. Malcolm Smith from Chelmsford in Essex, who runs his own business and says he's a great actor. And Vicky Hubble, a full-time mum from Birmingham, who says she has a cunning streak. So our six would-be pretenders are about to face questions on all sorts of subjects, but only you at home will know whether they've got them right or wrong. And if one of them is suspected of being a bit too smart, they can get voted off the game by the others. So the strategy for you guys is simple. If you're playing, you should already be pretending. Let's make a start. Round one. Every correct answer is worth £75. We put £75 into the prize pot. And in this round, the questions are all connected to aircraft and flight. Katie, we'll start with you. Complete the title of the orchestral work composed by Rimsky-Korsakov, The Flight of the... what?
Bumblebees.
Wayne, which supersonic passenger airliner had its final flight in 2003?
Concorde.
Catherine, in David Bowie's song Space Oddity, who is sitting in a tin can far above the world?
Cowboy.
Glenn, in the 2006 film starring Samuel L. Jackson, what type of reptiles terrorize passengers on a plane?
Snakes.
Malcolm, what was the name of the first satellite to be placed in orbit?
Sputnik.
Vicky, who had a hit with the 1950s album Come Fly With Me?
Frank Sinatra.
Catherine, you say you're a fantastic bluffer.
That's right, yes.
In what way?
I'm good at getting what I want when I need to. When I was a student, I bluffed my way out of an exam because I said I'd been burgled and that my laptop had been stolen. And I cried to the lecturer and he took pity on me. Thank goodness.
If things go really badly today,
yes.
Are you prepared to use tears?
I think that's a little bit beyond me now and my makeup might run.
Okay. Wayne. You're not going to use tears, are you?
I hope not.
I hope not. What's your strategy today?
Try and see if I can read people as well as I'd like to think I could, but hearing all the blurbs about these guys, I'm a bit worried because they all seem to be good bluffers or liars or cheaters in some form or another.
That's basically why they're here, yes. Vicky, you worked for years previously in customer services. Do you think that might be a big help?
I've dealt with a lot of people from every age range, every walk of life, culture, race, whatever, and in varying situations from being a holiday rep, working at an airport, in sales. So I've faced public all across, and I think I might have a good chance of reading people, but usually the people I'm reading are being honest, and today, obviously, nobody's going to be honest, so no. Probably not as good as it as I
You'll
thought I could
find
be.
That the rest of them are five of the most devious people you'll ever meet in your life. OK, let's move on. We'll talk to the other three in a couple of minutes. Round two is a doubles round. It does mean there's double the cash available for two correct answers at a time. You'll be given two song titles. I want you to tell me who had a number one hit with each of them. £75 for every one you get right. £900 are up for grabs, possibly this round. Wayne, we'll start with you. My Ding-a-ling.
Lulu.
Wake Me Up Before You Go-Go.
Wham.
Catherine. Another Brick in the Wall.
Police.
I Bet You Look Good on the Dance Floor.
A Jam.
Glenn. I Should Be So Lucky.
Kylie Minogue.
In the Summertime.
The Hollies.
Malcolm. Baby One More Time.
Lou Betts.
Message in a Bottle.
Dire Straits.
Vicky. Boombastic.
I could sing it for you, but
don't.
I won't.
Please don't.
Shaggy, I think.
Don't Look Back in Anger.
Oasis.
Katie. Barbie Girl.
Aqua.
Grace Kelly.
Mika.
Purely for you at home, not here in the studio. This is the score so far. Malcolm, you're very quiet.
So far.
You do say that body language is 93% of what we communicate. That does seem extraordinarily high.
93% of what people will perceive about you is body language. How you talk, how you gesticulate, and what impression you make just as you walk in. The other 7% of what you say, they're not really listening. They'll have made up their mind whether they like you or not the first time they see you.
So you've met five complete strangers this morning. Have you already more or less sussed them?
Yeah, five total liars.
Spot on then, Matt. Well done. Yeah. Katie, you're studying creative writing at the moment.
That's right, yes, I am.
Is that going to help?
Well, I try and use my stories more to communicate truth. But lies seem to pay better, so.
You're in good company here. If you win some money today, what would you like to do with it?
Well, I would like to spend some of it on charity, because I'm always getting approached by these charity street fundraisers, and I always sign up because I don't know where my bluffing skills go in this situation, but I'm running low on money, so I kind of need to refill that fund, really.
Okay. Glenn. Ruthless.
Absolutely, Chris.
Why?
Because I always see the end point and I go for it and I want to get it, and failure is not an option. I just always want to get to that point, and I'll take whoever I can along with me to help me get to that point, and then I will offload them when I get to that point if I have to.
Okay. Six very strange people. It's time for the first elimination vote. If you do successfully eliminate somebody, the value of each question will be doubled for the next rounds. So who do you want to basically put on a train with a one-way ticket home already? Have a look round. See if there's anybody you think is a serious threat this early in the game. Make your minds up, please, and all lock your votes in now. so. Six players all hoping to go home with some cash, but is one of them about to leave empty-handed? Find out who survives after the break. Don't go away.
Get comfortable with Dreams, Britain's favourite bed specialist. Season, transform yourself. Max Factor introduced new Miracle Touch Liquid Illusion, our first ever solid to liquid foundation that transforms to create a more perfect you. Create an illusion. Our ultimate even finish. Be you. Be beautiful. New Miracle Touch Liquid Illusion Foundation from Max Factor. Get your free sample at www.maxfactor.co.uk and experience a Miracle Touch. Imagine the softness of silk with the protection of always. Cosmopolitan readers have. In fact, 90% would recommend Always with Silk to their friends. Feels like silk, protects like always.
At Argos, spend £50 and get a free £5 gift card. Or spend £100 and get a free £10 gift card. Have a more Christmassy Christmas with Argos.
Get comfortable with Dreams, Britain's favourite bed specialist.
Welcome back to The Great Pretender. With only two rounds under their belt, one of these six players is already in danger of making a premature departure. Now, just for you at home, here's a reminder of who has answered the most questions correctly so far. Just before the break, everybody voted for the player they think is the greatest threat. If one person gets more votes than anybody else, they will be eliminated from the game. OK, let's reveal the vote. Katie, who did you decide you want to get out of here?
I voted for Malcolm. I don't think he got either of his music round questions right, but he definitely didn't get Britney's question right, which is Baby One More Time. And I thought that's a really, really well-known single.
Malcolm. What did you do?
Well, Chris, I voted for Katie.
Ah. Why?
For the simple reason, and I think she's already found it out, is that she's a different generation to me. Her style of music, the questions she knows the answers to, I don't.
Wayne, who did you vote to get rid of?
I also voted for Malcolm. I think he was overacting, if anything, on the getting the police one wrong. Considering Malcolm was the actor, I thought he hammed it up a little bit on that one.
Not a professional actor.
OK, we've got two for Malcolm. Malcolm, you're in danger at this moment. One for Katie. Catherine, what did you do?
Vicky. Only because the two questions that I think that Vicky got, I think she answered them beautifully, but with the old bit of the hamming up beforehand. Whereas I hadn't got a Scooby do what answers I had.
Vicky, what did you do?
I actually ended up voting for Katie. She seemed very confident with her answers. There was no umming and ahhing. She just gave her answers straight away. She scares me. She's a good bluffer and she worries me sick, so I'd like to see her gone.
Glenn, if you vote for Malcolm or Katie, one of them's out of here. What did you do?
I had absolutely no hesitation in who I was choosing. It was Katie. And that was because she has the edge on the rest of us on any questions that come up on the young, trendy music, and I think she had to go.
So, Katie, I'm sorry. You did too well, I think. I can tell you that Katie at that point was one of the leading scorers, so you did use your votes wisely and you eliminated certainly a possible threat. I'm afraid for you, Katie, the pretending is over. OK, carrying on. One already eliminated. The next round is potentially a very profitable test of your nerve because it's fingers on buzzers for this round. And, of course, it's a great chance to boost your score, and the money has now doubled. There is a second elimination coming up after the next round. And if you're too trigger-happy with your buzzer, you might be voted off. I'll describe a number of world leaders, and I want you to tell me who it is I'm talking about. Each correct answer now is worth £150 to the prize pot, so it's definitely worth somebody buzzing in, if you know the answer, and if you feel brave. OK, here we go. He came to power in 1959 following a revolution. The American government allegedly tried to assassinate him with an exploding cigar. Wayne.
Fidel Castro.
He was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize in 1993. He was arrested as a terrorist. Vicky.
Nelson Mandela.
She was born in Mayfair in London in 1926. Catherine.
Margaret Thatcher.
Margaret Thatcher said she liked him and we can do business together. Malcolm.
Ronald Reagan.
As well as being a political leader, he was also a poet. In 1934, he led his followers on the Long March. He wrote a little red book. Glenn.
Chairman Mao.
Right, purely for you at home, not for us here in the studio, these are the scores. Five remain. This is how they're all doing up to this point. Round four, music round. You'll each be played part of a song, the title of which does not appear in the lyric. I want you to tell me exactly what that title is. OK? Catherine, we'll start with you.
You fill up my senses like night in a forest, like the mountains in springtime.
I can tell you it's John Denver. What's the title?
Come Let Me Love You.
Glenn, your turn.
Unchained Melody.
Malcolm, here's yours.
The boys of the NYPD choir were singing Galway Bay, and the bells are ringing out for Christmas Day.
Something, A Tale of New York City.
Vicky, have a listen.
I see a little silhouette of a man.
Scaramouche, Scaramouche, will you do the fandango?
Thunderbolt and lightning, very, very frightening me. Because
that's Bohemian Rhapsody.
Wayne, what's the title?
Fanny made a plane into Paris.
Paperback writer.
These are the scores at this point after that round. How are you feeling, Catherine?
Not so hot, but I just want to get to the end, really, and sort of I'm very nervous about the people that are around me. I think they're very good and I think they're very deceptive.
Glenn, how are you doing?
I'm doing good. I've got to do my reverse ruthlessness. In normally I would cut the weak baggage, but I've got to try and keep the weak baggage. So, and I think I know who they are. I think I know who the strong performers are, so I think I know who I want to get rid of.
Malcolm, do you know who you are?
I think so, I hope so. I think I've worked out who the danger people are. So I just hope I can sort of stay till the next round, keep improving, hopefully. Fingers crossed.
Time for a second possible elimination. Now, again, if one of you receives more votes than the rest, you're out of here, and the value of the remaining questions goes up double again. So have a look round. Have a look at the people next to you. Do you see someone doing a lot better than they'd have you believe? Lock in your vote now. The votes are all cast. Let's see who you want to send packing at this stage. Wayne, what have you done?
I've gone for Malcolm. I think he's got the most wrong out of everyone, and I don't know whether that's just because of his lack of knowledge or whether maybe the questions have gone for a slightly different generation.
Malcolm, who are you trying to get rid of?
Today, Chris, I voted for Vicky. I think currently Vicky and Glenn are contending for the lead, and if I'm going to catch up, I have to get rid of someone who's winning.
So, Vicky, who have you tried to eliminate?
I'd like to return the favour. I voted for Malcolm. Actually, I don't buy into this. I don't know anything, and I'm underperforming, and I'm really finding it tough. I know he's got some questions right. He's just pretending he hasn't, and I just don't buy into his act at all.
OK, don't beat around the bush, say what you think. Glenn.
I found this really, really difficult, but I actually ended up voting for. Too quiet, too confident. I think the Beatles question, I didn't know the answer to it, but I knew it wasn't Paperback Writer, and I think everybody knew it wasn't Paperback Writer.
Well, I've got to give some answer, haven't
I? But I think you could have chosen a more plausible answer. I think you deliberately threw that one because you knew you were getting everything else right so far.
At the moment, there's two for Malcolm, one for Vicky, one for Wayne. Catherine, what have you done?
Malcolm.
There was a hint of viciousness when you said that.
Well, one, I like slapping this button, and two, I'm just not buying it. I just don't feel it. It's a gut thing.
I don't know whether you underplayed it or what you did.
No, I was just unlucky, Chris. Different day, different questions. I'd have come into my own, but...
I can tell you that Malcolm, and I think you know this, Malcolm was not a leader at that point. It does mean that somebody among our remaining four is playing a very sneaky game. Mm-hmm. But I'm afraid for you, Malcolm, the pretending is over.
Thank you.
So there are just four left now. They'll be with us till the end. So we're going on to round five. And because you successfully eliminated Malcolm, it does mean every correct answer from now on is worth £300. So this round, the questions are all connected to diamonds. Glenn, this time around, I'm going to start with you. Which Belgian city is known as the diamond-cutting capital of the world?
Antwerp.
Vicky, who plays the white mercenary Danny Archer in the 2006 film Blood Diamond?
Titanic bloke, Leonardo DiCaprio.
Wayne, which monarch celebrated a diamond jubilee in 1897?
1897. King of Belgium.
Catherine, in which 1953 film did Marilyn Monroe sing Diamonds Are a Girl's Best Friend?
Some Like It Hot.
OK, one more round to come. Strictly for you at home, not for us. This is the score at this moment. OK, last round. It's another doubles round. Two possible answers for double the cash, £300 for each right answer. serious chance to boost the bank up before the end of your questions. This round is all about bad decisions. I'll give each of you two scenarios, and I want you to tell me either who made the bad decision or what that bad decision was. We'll kick off the final round with you, Vicky. The inventor of the C5 electric vehicle.
Sir Clive Sinclair, I think.
The trader who caused the collapse of Barings Bank.
Leeson, Nick Leeson.
Wayne. The actor who celebrated his new love by jumping on Oprah Winfrey's couch.
Tom Cruise.
The weather forecaster who said there'd be no hurricane in 1987.
Michael Fish.
Catherine. The white elephant built in Greenwich to celebrate the year 2000.
The Millennium Dome.
The television interviewer who turned his back on Grace Jones during his UK chat show in 1980.
Oh.
Michael Parkinson.
Glenn. The Prime Minister who said there'd be peace for our time in 1938.
Neville Chamberlain.
The former goalkeeper and television presenter who said he was the son of God.
Oh. Ozzy Ardiles.
Okay, for the benefit of you at home, and as always, not for any of us here in the studio, these are your final scores. Right, I can tell you there is now a clear winner. So it's up to the rest of you to work out who it is. I'm going to send you all off to the waiting room, and we'll call you back one at a time. And I will tell one of you that you are today's great pretender. And it's then going to be up to you to try and keep that secret for the rest of the game. If you do, you'll go away with today's total, which is £3,975. If you don't manage to keep it secret, the other three will share that amount of money. Off you go. Lots of luck. Oh, and by the way, we will be watching you.
Like the idiot from hell for that football question.
Yeah,
I know
we're
nothing
just starting,
about sport.
We're just starting now, aren't we, with the whole acting thing?
No.
Yes, I think so.
I don't
come
mind.
On,
So you at home now know the identity of the great pretender. I'm still not at all sure, but in any case, whether he or she is, will they be able to hide their victory from everybody else and keep hold of today's full amount of £3,975? Find out after the break.
Get comfortable with Dreams, Britain's favourite bed specialist.
Have a more Christmassy Christmas. With Argos' top deals, this week only save up to a third on selected LCD TVs. And save up to half price on selected DVD players and recorders. Right now, get this DVD player for an incredible £9.99. Don't miss out. Reserve online or by phone for instant pickup. Don't shop for it. Argos it.
What is the state of that, eh? You stayed at music halls, then.
Hey, number one, please.
Westline.
Hiya. I'd like to know more about your broadband packages, please.
We've got just a thing, four different types, one for each of you. Nicky, I'm giving you just broadband, because all you ever do is look yourself up on the web. Mark, are you still spending days looking for Westlife videos? Broadband extra package. Kean, always yakking on the blower, simple home phone.
Very good.
Shane, the brains of the outfit. Home phone and broadband extra.
But isn't broadband a real faff to set up, Kean?
Just plug mine in and phum, I was away.
Where do we sign?
Just sign the form.
The People's Broadband at the People's Post Office. Now you can look like you've caught some sun while you fight seven signs of aging. Because Olay has combined its age-defying moisturizer with a touch of sunless tanner. Introducing Total Effects Touch of Sunshine. Olay's first age-defying cream that gives you gradual building color. New Olay Total Effects Touch of Sunshine.
Tesco Mobile. We try to keep things simple. That's why all of our tariffs have a flat rate. So you're always in control of what you're spending. After all, you probably prefer dialing numbers, not calculating them. Tesco Mobile, a little helps.
You've switched to good habits to save energy, so don't waste it. A Bosch AAA rated dishwasher heats only the exact amount of water needed. Unique spray arms deliver water efficiently, showering your dishes. And used with Finish Quantum, you achieve incredible cleaning results every time. Bosch and Finish, helping you do your bit.
Once there was a gnome who had the best job in the world. He was in charge of all kisses. But every year he had to dispose of all leftover kisses at the Well of Riddance. Until a mistletoe fairy whispered, "What a waste." So the gnome had an idea. He made all the leftover kisses into mistletoe kisses and sprinkled them far and wide. Mistletoe kisses from Galaxy.
Britain's best-selling pain-relieving gel is Ibuleve. People believe in the pain-relieving power of Ibuleve.
Earwax problems? Otex eardrops are clinically proven to reduce the need for syringing. So you can be clear to hear. Otex.
The Emporio Armani Classic Watch and Cufflink Set. From a selection of jewellery and watches found only at Ernest Jones.
Tesco Mobile. Now you can talk to your friends on the very latest top-of-the-range handsets. And when you spend £25 in store, we'll throw in something worth talking about too. Tesco Mobile. A little helps.
Coming up on London Tonight, we've some breaking news for you as a man is charged with murdering Rachel Nickell 15 years ago.
Plus, a 14-year-old is arrested for allegedly bringing a gun into school.
And future phone. You can buy papers, train tickets and make calls, but is it safe?
All the day's news and Boys to Men at 6.
Get comfortable with Dreams, Britain's favourite bed specialist.
Welcome back to The Great Pretender. For you at home, here's another reminder of the final state of play. Right, now the players have to try to figure out what you at home now know, the identity of today's Great Pretender. They have no idea at this point, and in fact, nor do I. But that's all soon about to change.
We have to find out
who
got most of the questions right. You did, I think.
I'm not sure.
Oh, Wayne, how are you, mate?
Not too bad, thank you.
So how do you think you're doing?
I'm pretty sure I'm not the Great Pretender. I think I dropped some really silly ones. Well, the Beatles one just threw me completely. Paperback writer.
Did you really not know it?
I really did not know that one, not from that excerpt, no.
Did you throw any questions on purpose? Because one of two of your answers, I thought that's a very strange answer.
King of Belgium. That Belgium one, I think because I was thinking of Glenn's answer.
Antwerp?
I had Belgium stuck in my head.
And you didn't throw my ding-a-ling?
Lulu.
That Lulu classic.
My ding-a-ling, I don't know. Oh, was it Lulu? Well, I don't know.
You did a very strange thing today. You were adamant that Malcolm had to go.
Malcolm. I was thinking on whether there'd be a lot of money in the pot either for me to take home or to be able to share out afterwards, and I just thought Malcolm was struggling on some of the questions. I didn't really think he was going to contribute.
That's an interesting tactic. Put your red chip in, and I can tell you from this side of your screen how well you did. Wayne, you are not the great pretender, which obviously doesn't come as that much of a shock.
No.
Who do you think it is?
I think it's Vicky. I think maybe she was a bit unlucky because she's had some very easy questions that would have been very hard to throw without looking stupid.
That's Bohemian Rhapsody.
OK, listen, you've got to find out who it is and you've got to convince the other two to agree with you.
Yep.
All right, mate, get back.
Thanks.
See you in a bit.
Do you actually care about me? Do you actually care what happens to me when I walk out the studio? Do you want to win the money?
I need a bit
of cash. Do you worry about, hurting my feeling or getting the money? See, obviously, you're quite bright, because you know all his answers as well.
No, I know he got them wrong. I don't know what the answers are.
Well, obviously, because you've just told me the answers.
I don't know what the Beatles one is.
So how are you?
I've got a really good idea now who it is. Definitely.
I'm sure you have.
Yeah,
I'm sure you have, because I'm sure Chris told you it was you.
Yeah, he's told me all the answers. He told me how many you got right, how many you got wrong.
Can you see if he's allowed to do that?
So how do you think you're doing?
Well, I just want to win a bit of cash. Wouldn't go amiss. I know I wasn't supposed to play the ditzy blonde thing, but I think I've just kept a little bit like that. I haven't got a Scooby do what answers I had. And I haven't got a clue, simply.
But you're doing the ditzy blonde thing now.
No, Chris. Honestly, because I have to be honest to you. But my only way to play it was to get all my questions wrong. Margaret Thatcher. Come, let me love you. Well, I just thought I'd let everybody else do the work, whereas I get all my questions wrong, they feel safe with me, I look like a bit of a blondette, perfect, I'm still here.
And also, Michael Parkinson got hit by Grace Jones.
Michael Parkinson.
Michael Parkinson famously got attacked by an emu and nearly got thumped by Muhammad Ali. He was never attacked by Grace Jones.
Michael Parkinson, he's not you, is he, Chris?
No, he's not me, and I haven't been punched by Grace Jones either. Do you think you're the great pretender?
No, I do not think for one iota.
Take your chip, put it in the top, and I'll tell you from this side of your screen what you did. Catherine, you are not the great pretender. Why are you so happy? You came here to be the great pretender. You're not.
No, I was never going to make it as the great pretender.
Well, probably not.
Let's be honest.
Okay.
Questions. They're not my forte.
No. So who is it?
I think it is Vicky, and I'm going to go with my gut instinct.
Get back in there. You've got to find out who they are, and you've got to convince the other two to agree with you. You must agree. If you're a split vote, they get the money. OK? Get busy.
OK.
See you in a while.
Thank you, Chris.
I think it's Catherine. Okay. That's my gut instinct is Catherine, because she's being really quiet and mouthy, and I'm blondie, and she's so sly, and she's so good. And I just want a bit of money, and I don't really want a bit, and I want a bit of money.
If they'd gone on like that, I would have been sunk. Completely. We all would have been sunk, I think, but we're doing right. Oh, look.
Glenn, my love,
you're
next.
Oh, you're glowing. You're absolutely glowing.
You do look quite happy.
I'm blooming delighted because...
You're the great pretender,
you
right?
Are blatantly the great pretender.
Can I just ask you, why are you both discounting Glenn?
Glenn, how are you?
Hi, Chris. I'm fine. It's getting a bit fraught in there.
Are you sure you're not the great pretender?
I could probably bet all the prize money.
You're not really looking me in the eyes as you're saying it, though, are you?
I'm looking all around the room, but in my eyes.
You're deflating. I promise. I'm not
the great pretender.
Promise I'm not the great pretender.
No, I'm not, and I think you know it.
Well, you said to me, to everybody at the top of the show,
failure is not an option. I will succeed if I am the great pretender, and I will also succeed if I manage to go home with at least some money.
You did seem to be milking it a lot.
Unchained Melody. Yeah, but it's...
Yeah, come on.
No, it's the lights, it's the absolute...
No, it's not any of that. It's called bluffing, it's called pretending I'm not as bright as I actually am. It's exactly what it is.
Right, okay.
I mean, what was that about former footballer who believed he was the son of God?
Ozzy Ardiles.
Yes, Ozzy Ardiles. Hello?
I
Ozzy Ardiles, how many times did he claim to be the son of God?
My worst subject is sport. And I just think I have publicly humiliated myself on national TV with the only answer that everybody knows.
How do you think you've done?
I think I'm in there with a good chance, but I think someone has pipped me.
Put your chip in, and I can tell you exactly what you've done. Glenn, you are not the Great Pretender.
Right, that makes it much easier now.
Failure is not an option.
So I've got to go in and make sure that I do get a share of that money.
So who is it?
I think it's Vicky.
Definitely. I don't think that I got this. I wasn't confident of the answers. I didn't know the answers. They were pure guesswork. But right, if you say I've got them right, then hallelujah, so be it.
Are you feeling nervous?
Not really, because I know I'm not the Great Pretender, so I'm not really bothered.
You don't know yet.
Here he is.
Right, we have got some work to do, guys.
Oh.
Your turn, Vicky.
I
want to go home with some money. And at the moment, I'm not going home with anything, so...
I don't know if you're deflecting it, Glenn.
Honestly, I'm not. I thought I was in with a chance, to be honest. And I'm not now.
Hiya, how are you?
I'm very well, thank you.
Does that Catherine ever take a breath?
No.
She is full on, isn't she?
Yes, just a bit.
Vicky, at the top of the show,
you
said, I don't give a stuff about you lot.
Well, I don't. I've got to be honest, I don't. Well, do you actually care about me?
You seem to deliberately slow down towards the end.
Leeson. Nick Leeson.
Definitely.
Yeah, okay, I deliberately perhaps thought about things a little bit more than... Actually, I could have probably popped out the answer straight away without any pondering on most of them, if I'm honest.
Exactly, Blood Diamond.
Titanic bloke. Leonardo DiCaprio.
Yes.
It was rubbish.
Do you think you're managing to keep a low profile from the others or not?
I got Dingling wrong.
I can't remember Vicky getting any wrong at the moment.
I can't remember if Vicky got any wrong.
They're all convinced it's me.
Do you think you're the Great Pretender?
No.
Would you like to be?
Coming into it, yes, I would have done, because I'd have said it was easier to deflect from being the Great Pretender than trying to find out who it is. But having just left that room there where they're all gunning for me anyway, no, I don't want to be the Great Pretender.
Put the red chip in. I can tell you from here how you did. Vicky, you are the Great Pretender.
No.
What will you do?
Just carry on as I have been, so I think if there's any change in me now, it will be really noticeable.
You've only somehow got to persuade one person to vote for somebody else. That's all you've got to do. One person.
One person. That's all I've got to get. OK,
thank
you very much.
All right, darling, good luck. Fingers crossed for you.
Bye.
We all answered questions quite steadily, but with wrong ones in there, and I just don't recall seeing Vicky having a bad round, really.
Yeah.
It could be a space cowboy as well, sir.
Hello.
Hello.
Have you all decided it's me then? Because that's where I was when I left. So has anything changed since?
Well, I'm tempted to change my mind.
Not really.
Well, can I just tell you that if you now vote for me, you are really making the biggest mistake ever.
So Vicky is today's Great Pretender, and all she has to do is keep that secret to herself and somehow swerve the focus onto Wayne, Catherine or Glenn. Can she do it? We're about to find out.
I'm really excited, but really nervous now because I know it's this close, but can all be taken away like that if I don't manage to sort those three out in there. Hopefully go and try and convince at least one of them in there that it's not me.
Here they come, the four musketeers. Well, you've all been trying to catch one another out because you do know one thing for sure. One of you four is today's Great Pretender. One of you four at this moment is £3,975 better off. Everybody at home knows who that person is, and I now know who that person is. But unless you can pin down who they are, the rest of you will go away with nothing, and they will walk away £3,975 better off. Now, watch each other's body language very closely. I'm going to ask you in turn to look me in the eye in front of everybody else. on television and tell me you are not the Great Pretender, and one of you will be lying. Wayne, tell me you're not the Great Pretender.
Chris, 100% categorically, I am not the Great Pretender. I do not currently have that amount of money sitting in my pocket waiting to leave here.
Ooh. Catherine.
I am certainly not the Great Pretender. I don't actually have that in me. When it comes to being with my friends and being honest, I'm good. I'm a good, reliable friend. And today, I felt that when I've blagged in the past, today I couldn't. I got the questions wrong. Simple as that.
Glenn, tell me you're not the Great Pretender.
Chris, I am not the Great Pretender. My conscience could not be clear going away, taking money from these other people, and I am not the Great Pretender. I got questions wrong. People know that. I'm not the Great Pretender.
Vicky, tell me you are not the Great Pretender.
I'm not the Great Pretender. I'm not a liar. I am an honest person. And if people don't believe that I'm not the Great Pretender, then they're all going to go home with nothing apart from the one little happy soul that's sitting there now knowing that they are the Great Pretender.
OK, I want you just to say who you think the Great Pretender is. Wayne, give me a name.
Vicky.
Catherine, give me a name.
Vicky.
Glenn, give me a name.
Vicky.
Vicky, give me a name.
Wayne.
£3,975. One of them has that at this moment. Will they keep it? Find out after the break.
Get comfortable with Dreams, Britain's favourite bed specialist.
Something tells me something's gonna happen tonight.
Why rush around looking for Christmas presents? At Argos, this week only save up to half price on all games tables. Like this football table for under £50. And save £100 when you buy the Xbox 360 with 10 games, all for under £220. Have the full Argos range delivered to your door. Don't shop for it, Argos it.
Imagine if every time you brushed, you had the power of the Oral-B experts helping you brush better. Introducing Oral-B Triumph. With Smart Guide. Its wireless monitor tells you when to switch sides, how long to brush, even when you're brushing too hard. And its MicroPulse head cleans deep for healthier gums. Put the power of the Oral-B experts behind your smile. Oral-B Triumph with Smart Guide. Brush like a dentist.
Or is a miserable word. Or makes you choose. Or is a bore. And is different. And says, why choose? Have both if you like. So pick a credit card that gives you 0% on balance transfers until December 2008 and 0% on purchases until March 2008. Platinum Plus from MBNA. Call 0800 1055 10 or visit mbna.co.uk.
Under cover of night and blanket of snow, one man works hard to make Christmas glow. He chooses sparkles from far and near to help you say it better to someone held dear. He works through the night and is only content when each little sparkle says exactly what's meant. So you see their faces full of delight and be happy in knowing you've said it just right. The new H. Samuel Christmas Collection. H. Samuel helps you say it better.
King number one album out now.
Get into the festive spirit with exclusive ranges of decorations from B&Q.
Yeah, let's do it, let's fall in love.
Celebrate Christmas at Morrison's. Buy a 1 litre bottle of Baileys for only £10. Creamy. Morrison's, savings to make your Christmas.
Bertolli. Enjoy the goodness of the olive tree every day.
Get comfortable with Dreams, Britain's favourite bed specialist.
Welcome back to the final part of today's Great Pretender, where at this moment the other three contestants are convinced that Vicky is the Great Pretender, but is one of these other three just sitting there quietly milking it and discreetly enjoying it, swerving everything across to Vicky? Vicky, who do you think's the Great Pretender?
But it just seemed to me that back in the waiting room, everyone suddenly jumped on the bandwagon of blaming me when only one person had been in to see you, and that was Wayne. Wayne came in, saw you, came out, and suddenly, oh, it's Vicky, and everyone's joined in. And I think that's an exceptionally clever ploy by someone who's probably the Great Pretender and is trying to deflect it from themselves.
Barking up the wrong tree.
And what about Glenn?
Here's my other option.
We've come to a decision.
I'll take everybody to the top and then I'll cast them all aside. No. I think he's very clever with that.
This time I'm taking everyone with me and we're going to go home with a share of it.
If you had any wrong, then it was maybe one or two, whereas I can remember two or three from each of us.
But you think you know everybody's answers
then? All I'm saying to you, failure is not an option. If you go home with nothing, you have completely and utterly publicly failed.
Exactly.
Oh, say it how it is.
I think Wayne is... He got some easy questions wrong, but he might have got all his others right, and I don't know about that.
Right, I'm going to give you 60 seconds. You have to agree. If you're a split vote, you're dead. Go.
Listen to me. You are all making a huge, huge mistake. No, okay?
You are getting nervous because you've got the money in the bank. You have.
Okay, well, I'll tell you what. You've all made up your mind, so you're going to lose your money.
Donation rounds.
I'm
being serious. You said you wanted to take money home with you.
I'm worried about Wayne.
You wanted to take money home with you. Wayne led you from the minute he walked through the door to somebody else.
She's trying to push on to me now because she knows that we've got her.
No.
She knows we've got her and we're going to take a share.
I'm sorry, but that makes me nervous.
He led you from the minute he walked through. I want some of that money.
You've got 25 seconds left, guys.
My instincts have been with Vicky all the way.
Vicky has got a lot of the questions right.
Can I just say to you, the minute he walked through, the only one person that heard who was the Great Pretender or not was Wayne.
Wayne is trying to put it onto me as well.
It's Wayne. I want you to vote. I want you to tell me who is the Great Pretender. You must agree. All vote now. Right, make your mind up time. How have you voted?
I voted for Vicky.
So you haven't changed your mind. Okay, Glenn, how have you voted?
I have voted for Vicky.
Still shaking her head. Vicky, how have you voted?
Wayne.
Catherine, you looked like you were going to be swayed. At one point, you were going to change your mind. Oh, what did you do?
I think I've made a mistake, but I have voted for Vicky. But when you mentioned the money, just after, Glenn went like this.
Failure is not an option.
I know.
His words, not mine.
It's looking wobbly.
Vicky, tell him. Are you the Great Pretender? Yes, she is. And you were
scared.
Well done, guys.
You were scared. Catherine, you were not sorry at all.
I wouldn't have been
sorry. So
believe me, I wouldn't have been sorry.
I want to shake. I'm going over about 1,500 quid. I want to shake.
I wouldn't have been sorry.
I was thinking it was Wayne. I really did think it was going to be Wayne.
Vicky, they nailed you. You had it. £3,975 and you had it in the hand.
I have a moral picture. I won the quiz.
Now I'm definitely glad I got the money off you.
That's it from us. So the great pretender has been unmasked. That's about it. Join me next time to see if a new batch of players unmask the pretender again and share the money out amongst themselves. Or can somebody win by pretending that they've lost? It happens on the show where your greatest defense is pretense. From all of us on the great pretender, listen to them. Goodbye. Vicky. Big bye.
It's the conclusion of our interactive three-part story in The Bill. So expect a dramatic climax tonight at 8 here on ITV1.